Hi everyone, welcome back. Now that we know how to create watch lists in Optuma, I'm going to spend the next few minutes showing you how they can be used and some of the versatility behind them. So on the screen here, I have already opened a watch list here and added some columns. Now we've got sector name from our fundamental data, as well as 1 month percentage, is the moving average 50 sloping up, and also the RSI value, the weekly RSI value. Now, these have been created, the last three columns at least, have been created using the Optuma scripting language, which is a language that we've developed to help you create these types of analysis. Now, it's not a programming language. We try to make it as simple as we could, but I highly recommend you go to the scripting videos on learn.optuma.com. We've got introduction, intermediate, and advanced, and we'll take you through the steps of and showing you lots of examples of how the scripting can be used, not just in watch lists, but other areas of the software as well, such as scanning and backtesting, page headers, and things like that. So for this example, I've just already added them to the watch list, but I'll show you how we can add the sector name or header. Another example of how to open a watch list. So I'm going to double click on the background and then expand ASX shares, S&P, top 50, and then open list as watch list. And then we're going to click on the plus icon. And so to add the sector name, I'm just going to, in the search box there, I'm going to search for sector. And under fundamental field, that's the one we want. So sector name, and that's added it to the watch list. Now what we could also do, any column that you want to sort on, just click and it will sort either at ascending or descending for any column. So there's by performance, daily performance, and also you can alphabetize them as well. If we right-click on a column, we get the options here. Now, what we can do is group by column. And when we do that, you'll see in this list, all the sectors have been grouped together with the gray headers separating them. So all the finance are together, energy minerals, so on and so forth, as we scroll down. And what we can do is collapse those groups. So that's the little icon in the top left of the watch list. And then say we just want to look at finance, we can just expand that group, energy minerals and so on. Another option is now that we can right click in the gray chart header of the column, and we can create summaries. So I just right-clicked in the change percent column on one of those gray headers, and you see summary type there has been set to none. But what I want to do is get the average. And now what that's calculated in that gray bar is the average for those groups. So for energy minerals, the average was minus 0.16%, which is the straight average of those four components or members of that group in my watch list. Let's add another column that will display a value. So I'm going to click on new and then script column. And again, I encourage you to go see the scripting videos. I'm not going to go into detail here how we create these values, but I'm just going to type in here RSI. And then I want the 14 period based on a week, and then apply that. And that's now going to, if I expand all those groups, that column there is now the weekly value of the RSI. So I can name that column. If I right click RSI weekly, and we can format that column as well. So if I right click on that blue title there, we can column type, I can change it to a number, and set the number of decimals and also align it as well. So I can put it in the center of the column. And again, with the gray headers, I can summarize the members of each group. So I can right click summary type average. So we get an average RSI value for those watchlist groups. Now you can add as many columns as you like, and you can also move them around. So I'm going to click on RSI weekly and drag it to the left and then put it there. Likewise, I can move sector and put that there. Now, if you want to delete a column, you can just mouse over and there's a little cross in the top right corner and we click that to delete it. So to clear the grouping, you can right click on the column that it's grouped by and select clear grouping. So what we can do now is right click on the change percent header in that column, go down to group by column and select any of these options. So I can do decile, quartile, positive or negative, or we can set the number of bins. So decile is 10, quartile is 4, but we can select any of those numbers. So let me just select decile. So now it's grouped that watch list into 10 buckets, each based on the change percent column. So again, we can collapse all of those in one go, and you can see the top 10, the top decile had an average return of 2.2% for that day. And again, you can click on the columns and they'll be sorted within each group. So that's in descending order, and I'll click again to the ascending order, and so the highest at the top of the group. So that's a bit of a brief overview of watch lists, but there are extra actions and properties that we can use. So if we right click on the watch list, or we can roll out the actions and panels properties panel on the left hand side with that icon, you'll see there's a number of options here, one of which is copy CSV values to clipboard. So if we select that, I just clicked on that, so all that information in that watch list is now on the clipboard. So we can go to somewhere like Excel, create a new sheet, and I'm going to paste in there. So because it's CSV, we'll have to do the text to columns to get those into individual columns, but you'll see all that information. So whatever columns are added to the watch list in Optuma can be copied and put into Excel fairly easily. Some of the other properties available in that section, if we scroll down a bit, we can change the font size. So to make it easy to read, or if you're printing these watch lists out, we can show a summary row. So that puts a row at the top for everything in the watch list. So and we can count as well. So if we right click in the sector name column and go to count, then the summary row, there's 50 total in the watch list and then 5 within each group because we group by decile. Okay, one final thing I'd like to go over in this session is the use of watch list layouts. Now you can see that at the top of the layout there, it says no layout. So what I can do is click on that and give it a name. So I'm going to call this layout performance. So all these columns that I've added, so I've got 1 month, percent, 3 month, year to date, and whether the moving averages are sloping up or not, I can now apply these columns to any other watch list very easily. So I'm going to open up a new list. So symbol lists, this one I'm going to apply the spider sectors, open as a watch list, and where it says no layout, and I'm now going to select performance, and those columns have been automatically added. So it's another great way of easily adding tools and indicators and columns to your watch list. You don't have to add them manually every single time. If you save it as a watch list layout, they can be applied to any other watch list that you create. So that's a brief overview of some of the features of watchlists. Now they are very, very flexible. You can have as many columns as you like with as many values and formulas being calculated. A lot of users like to create true-false sort of radar screens so you can sort certain conditions so all the true values just appear and grouped together. I encourage you to play around with those. And as I said, if you're interested in the scripting language, go back to the learn.optuma.com site and look at those videos because it really does add an extra level of power to the software. Thanks very much.